you what it is the Lord Jesus went through for everybody in this room. Everybody that's here, you should really take notice and watch and see the things that the Lord has done so that you could be free from the effects, from the penalty of sin. Whether you are already saved, believer in Jesus Christ, or whether you have not confessed Christ yet, we all should be mindful of what the Lord has done for us. And this is a good opportunity to put your mind on that. Here we are. We are getting ready for Easter. And so we're glad that you're here with us as we get the Easter season going. And we want to thank you for coming out and being a part of this depiction of our wonderful Savior. And we want it to be like it's a church event, so we have ushers up here. And we're going to take up an offering before the play tonight. And the offering is, it's a free will offering. You give what you want to give, doesn't matter. Give one penny or give $1 million if you want to. I'm not going to limit you on that. But don't feel obligated to give anything, because this is a ministry, and we want you to be blessed tonight. So if you want to be a contributor to this ministry of the gospel, you can contribute, and I pray that God would put it to your account. I want to report to you that last night it is confirmed that we had at least one soul come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ last night. And we celebrate that eternal gift of salvation. We celebrate what the Lord is doing, and I'm believing for many more souls to come into the kingdom of God, especially in these coming days. Because if you look around, you'll see our King is soon coming. And he gave us his word to declare that there are signs we can be looking for. And friends, we need to open up our eyes and see our Lord is soon coming. Lift up your head, your redemption draweth nigh. Amen. So, we're going to get real religious right here, and we're going to take up this offering. I'm going to pray. Would you bow your heads with me? Father, we love you. We honor you. We bless you. We thank you tonight. We ask, God, that your Spirit, Lord, would saturate this house. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that your Spirit, Lord, would deal with every heart that's in this room. And Lord, I pray you would stir us, everyone. Lord, stir us to a closer relationship. Stir us, Lord God, to do what it is you're calling us to do in this last day. And God, if there be anyone here that doesn't know you, I pray, Lord, right now, you would begin that work with your Spirit in their heart. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Bless this offering. Amen. All right. Right after the offering is over, we're going to turn the lights out. And we're going to give you a preview of how dark it gets in here, okay? Just so you know. As a matter of fact, if you have to go to the restroom, now would be a great time to do that. Because these aisleways here are active all throughout the play. And they are active mainly when it is dark. So the men's room and the ladies' room is right behind the sound booth. If you head directly toward the bright light, just head right directly back straight there, you'll see that there's a women's room on the right hand. You go through that set of doors, women's room's on the right, men's room on the left. And so now would be a great time to do that if you have to do that. In just a moment, we're going to give you a preview of what it's going to be like in here in the dark. And if you can, please, keep your children, if you have small children, keep them out of the aisleways. And if you can, keep yourself out of the aisleways, especially when it's dark, because you might end up being a speed bump in the play. So you might want to just stay out of the aisleways as much as you possibly can. Don't think, well, when next time the lights go out, I'll get up and go to the restroom because nobody will see me. That's right, nobody will see you. And they will run directly over top of you. So, and we don't want any accidents. We don't want anyone to be hurt. So just be mindful of that. And also, the Apostle Peter just came up to me and told me to have everyone silence their cell phone. So if you would, just do that if you can right now. Just silence it, and then that way it won't have anybody, any distractions. Because the enemy wants nothing more than to distract somebody who's receiving the message, the hope of glory, receiving the message that there is salvation for this day, and his name is Jesus. Can I get an amen in the house of God? His name is Jesus. And if you'll believe on him tonight, you can be free. You can be free. You can leave this place free tonight. Amen. Have we done with the offering? All right, let's give them a preview of what it's going to be. Wait just a moment. We got people going back to their seats. People moving about here. This is how someone got caught last night when we turned the lights off at the beginning, and I don't know if they ever made it back to their seat. Okay. All right, let's give them a preview. All right. Also, if you have your cell phone out and you're on your cell phone, it lights up a whole section. So just try not to do that, because the darkness is a part of the play. So we want you to be fully immersed in the play. So if you can, just keep from getting your cell phone out and allow the Lord to have this time to be able to minister. Maybe somebody right next to you that the Lord is affecting, and your cell phone could be a distraction to them. So, all right, we're going to start in about 3 minutes. We're going to give you 3 minutes. When the lights go out, I will say, lights out. All right? So, thank you for coming. God bless you.
When are we going to go out? Sorry about that. When are we going to go out? Y'all need to go too.
One minute. Okay, guys, we got about 30 seconds and then the lights are going to be going out. So just be prepared. Alrighty, lights out.
Go back with us some 2,000 years ago to a time of anticipation. A time in which the prophets had spoke of and had written that a Messiah and Savior would come to redeem the sins of the world. Born in a lowly stable, he was despised at birth as King Herod sought to kill him. Later, as a young boy, he astounded the wise as he taught in the temple, but was introduced as a man by one crying in the wilderness named John the Baptist, who said, "Behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world." Each day thereafter was filled with excitement and miracles. His fame spread like fire as he healed the lame, the blind, and all those that were oppressed of the devil. He even raised the dead. Among the excitement and hope that he had brought was extreme opposition from the priests, scribes, and Pharisees, who saw Jesus as one that perverted the very heart of their religion. Some turned back, but many would follow a path that would lead them to a view of the cross.
Praise the Lord and make music to your name. Oh, God was time to proclaim your love and faithfulness all the day and through the night. I'm alive.
My sister, may you increase thousands upon thousands, and may your offsprings possess the gates of their enemy. Hooray!
Hooray!
Wine.
There is no more.
There's no more wine? There's no more wine? There's no more wine?
They have no wine.
What does that have to do with me? My time has not yet come.
Whatever he saith to do, you do it.
Fill the water pots with water.
Thank you.
Oh, they have saved the best wine for now. Let the celebration continue.
Praise the Lord and make music to your name, O God Most High, to proclaim your love and faithfulness all the day and through the night. La la la, la 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la.
If I could just get to the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole.
Who touched me?
Lord, all these people, and you ask, who touched you?
Jesus, it is I. I have suffered with a blood disorder for 12 years. I've seen many physicians, and I've spent all of my money. I've heard of the great things that you have done, and I knew that if I could just get to the hem of your garment, that I would be made whole.
Daughter, your faith has made you whole. Now go in peace and be free from your plague.
I'm healed. I'm healed. I'm healed. I'm healed. Thank you, Jesus. I'm healed. Thank you, Jesus.
Don't be afraid. Only believe. No one come except for you, Peter, James, and John. Why are you sad and crying? She's not dead. She's only asleep.
But she is dead.
Remove the unbelievers. Little girl, I say to you, arise. Jairus, behold your daughter. You without sin cast the first stone. Where are your accusers? Does no one condemn you?
No one more.
Then neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more.
Thank you.
mercy upon us.
Go and show yourself to the priest and offer him the gift that Moses commanded. Were there not 10 cleansed, and only one comes back to give glory to God? Where are the other 9? Your faith has made you whole. Now go in peace.
Thank you, Jesus.
I say to you, arise.
A prophet has risen among us.
Surely God has visited his people.
This is a desert place, and these people, they've been here all day. Send them away into the villages where they can go and look for food and lodging.
We don't need to send them away. Give them something to eat.
But Lord, all we have are these 2 fish and 5 loaves.
Thank you.
would not have died.
Your brother will live again.
I know he shall live again in the resurrection at the last day.
I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he were dead, yet will he live. And he that believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?
Yes, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of the Most High, which should come into the world.
Lord, if you would have been here, our brother would not have died.
Where have you laid him?
Come see, Lord, come see.
Roll away the stone.
Lord, by now surely he stinks. He's been dead 4 days.
Did I not say that if you would believe, you would see the glory of God? Father, I thank you that you hear me. And I know that you always hear me. And I say this now for the people that stand by, so that they'll believe that you sent me.
Caiaphas?
Yes, Annas?
We've received the reports that this Jesus of Nazareth is causing more trouble than we're willing to handle.
I know. Something has to be done.
I've studied the 12 that follow him. I think there's one we may be able to reach. Let's send for Judas. Take this to Judas Iscariot. He's the one that manages the money. Maybe we can entice him.
I think we will.
Here he comes now.
Yeah.
Judas, I see you've received our message. Please, come in. Thank you.
Judas, a drink. Judas, we understand that you are a follower of Jesus, but unlike you, we are unsure of his ways. We in the Sanhedrin would love to meet with this Jesus, clear up any misunderstandings that we may have.
That can be arranged, if you're willing to pay my price.
Judas, we understand that a workman is worthy of his hire. Exactly what is your price?
30 pieces of silver, nothing less.
30 pieces of silver?
Annas! Judas, 30 pieces of silver is just a reward. We thank you, and we look forward to meeting with this Jesus, but how will we know him?
I'll greet him with a kiss.
See?
Caiaphas, I can't believe you gave that man 30 pieces of silver.
Annas, I was willing to pay 100.
I remember the day I rode into Jerusalem on a colt, just as the prophet had said. For it was written, Behold, your king is coming to you, gentle, and mounted upon a donkey, even upon a colt, the foal of a beast of burden. A great crowd had gathered and began to shout and sing, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! The people thought I had come to establish a new kingdom, and I had. Not in Jerusalem, but rather in their hearts. Soon they would decide that my way was not their way, and they would cease to sing and praise their new king. Ah, but for those few moments when they did believe that the fulfillment of the prophets and the hope of the ages had come to them, For that brief moment, all heaven and earth rejoiced.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King. Praises, praises, praises now we sing. Glory to the King of Kings.
Singing and praising faded away as quickly as it had begun. In a short time, the crowd would raise its voice again, but this time it would not be in praise. In those last days, I tried so hard once again to show the people my Father's way. I even spoke in parables of the kingdom of God so that all might understand, but they would not hear. Sometimes I wondered if anyone had ever heard. A handful of men that had followed me faithfully for such a short time, had they really heard? Could they really know? The last night we were together, I tried so hard to help them understand.
Understand. Do
The disciples, except for one who betrayed me, pledged their love and devotion for me that night. Still I knew that at the end all would forsake me. I even told them how it had been written, "I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock shall be scattered abroad." Peter said even if it meant his death, he would not deny me, and all the others agreed that they too had such devotion. Knowing that my hour was near, I went to a garden called Gethsemane to pray. And these same men who were willing to die with me only moments before would now find it difficult to stay awake and pray with me. But they would understand soon enough what this had all been about. The garden was the most agonizing part of those final moments. I had known for a time what my outcome would be, but now that it was here, I wondered, could I bear it? Was there another way?
Father, Father, is there no other way? Father, I know not what to pray. I've always sought to do Thy will, and that is my desire still. But why do I feel so alone? Sorrow I have never known. Is there a way that you can see to let this cup pass from me?
Betray me with a kiss?
Seize him!
Peter, no. Those who live by the sword die by the sword.
Get him!
You keep it.
You earned it.
I don't know no Jesus.
It is you.
I done told you, I don't know this Jesus.
Surely you are one of them. You are a Galilean. Your speech betrays you.
I already told you, I don't know this Jesus.
I say unto thee, that this night before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me three times.
Oh Lord, what have I done? What have I done? What have I done?
Thank you.
is the meaning of bringing this mob of people into my hall at this hour? You have disrupted my morning and my peace and my quiet. Caiaphas, Annas, you do realize that this is not a religious court for you all to iron out your doctrinal disputes.
Yes, Pilate, we do understand that. But we have here a matter that is much more than just a doctrinal dispute.
Well, get on with it. I ain't got all day.
Pilate, we have found that this man, Jesus of Nazareth, he distorts our people's views on the relationship between God and the state. And furthermore, he perverts the very heart of our religion.
I'm not concerned with people who break your religious laws. Need I remind you that as governor, I am to administer Roman justice and keep the peace.
Yes, Pilate, we know that. But this man also threatens the established order. And if he were not a criminal, we wouldn't have brought him to you.
He calls himself the Christ, the Anointed One.
Oh, you know some Greek, I see. I too know some Greek. Tell me, what has he done? Has he spoken against the emperor? Has he spoken against Rome?
Well, Pilate, not directly.
Not directly, then he's no concern of mine. Take him and judge him according to your law.
But Pilate, this man Jesus of Nazareth, he's done nothing but cause problems. If we were a self-governing nation, then we would have the right to exact punishment, which, under the law of Moses, is death.
He made a triumphant entry into Jerusalem, calling himself the King of Jews.
King of the Jews? All right. I'll talk to your Jesus.
He's not our Jesus.
Then whose? Bring him forth. Is this the man you think is so dangerous? Is this the man that aspires to be king? Come, come. Tell me, what have you done to make these people so angry?
Pilate, he said he was a king.
Let him speak. Are you a king?
No, he's not a king.
Said, let him speak. Are you the king of the Jews?
Are you asking because you want to know? Or because others have told you that about me?
What kind of answer is that? You're speaking riddles. Am I a Jew? Your own people and high priests have brought you to me. Tell me, what have you done?
My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my people would fight so that I wouldn't be handed over to the Jews.
Speak of a kingdom, therefore you must be a king. Are you a king?
I was born for one purpose, to speak the truth. All that hear my voice hear truth.
Truth? You stand in front of me looking like this, and you want to talk about truth? What is truth? I've searched for truth from the great writings of scholars, and I've found no truth. Search for truth from the deity of the gods. All I found was vanity and hypocrisy, and you, a pitiful Nazarene, stand in front of me and want to talk to me about truth? This man's no criminal. He's a dreamer. You ought to concern yourself with greater enemies than this.
But Pilate, this man's teachings have caused great contention among the people throughout Judea. It started in Galilee, and now it's spread here into Jerusalem.
Is he a Galilean?
Yes, Pilate he is.
Then why have you brought him to me?
For trial.
For trial? But isn't he under Herod's jurisdiction?
He is.
I thought so. Take him to Herod. Let Herod judge him.
But Pilate.
I said take him to Herod. Herod's in Jerusalem. Herod must judge him.
But your excellency.
I've spoken. Centurion, clear the court.
Bring him. Clear the way. Move. Move.
Well, Caiaphas, what do you suppose we do now?
Annas, I'm not really sure.
You're not sure? What do you mean you're not sure? I thought that you were sure that if we would take Jesus to Pilate, then Pilate would sentence him to be crucified and not send him to Herod.
Annas, it doesn't make any sense. As long as I've known Pilate, I've never seen him act like this. It was like he was afraid of Jesus. He didn't want anything to do with him.
And with all the charges that we brought before Pilate concerning this Jesus of Nazareth, how is it that he didn't issue a just sentence of death?
Pilate is caught in the middle. He wants nothing to do with this. He wants to wash his hands of the matter, Annas. We have to put more pressure on him.
But Pilate's no pushover, and he's already said that he found no fault in this Jesus. What if we find out, what if his followers find out that you convene the Sanhedrin in the middle of the night, and then his following is just going to continue to grow even more rapidly than it already has? I just hope we're doing the right thing.
The right thing? Annas, you ask if we're doing the right thing? This man has done nothing but cause trouble from day one. He claims to be the Son of God. He calls himself the Son of God. This man is a blasphemer. He even called us vipers. And you ask if we're doing the right thing, Annas.
Now you listen, I never said that I believed in this so-called King of the Jews. I'm just a little concerned, that's all.
And let me assure you, so are his followers. Where are they now? Scattered about and hiding?
You know, I think we're overlooking one important thing that may cause Pilate to change his mind.
What are you referring to?
Well, really, it's quite simple. Tell me, how many governors have been executed since Caesar Tiberius has taken power?
It's countless. Rome has never seen an emperor as brutal as Caesar.
And why were those governors executed?
A great deal of them were due to treason.
So, if Pilate doesn't sentence Jesus to be crucified, this so-called King of the Jews, under Roman law, that's treason.
Surely Pilate fears his own life. He knows that that's high treason. And surely he values his life more than Jesus's.
Let's go put more pressure on Pilate.
Let's go.
Yes, Centurion, what is it?
Your Excellency, I don't wish to disturb you, but I've just come from Herod's court, and I think we may have a problem.
Can't you see that I'm a very busy man? Say what you must and trouble me no further.
Your Excellency, I don't want to disturb you on this day, but right now there's a mob of people beyond the corridor wishing to talk to you about this Jesus of Nazareth.
What? I have made it clear I have nothing more to say about this Jesus of Nazareth. Herod is to judge him.
But Herod refuses to judge
him. For what reason?
Because the Sanhedrin, which brought him the trial, is located right here in Jerusalem.
If he can find any excuse, he will. Very well, send them in.
Bring him!
Let's go.
I find it beyond reason that you wish to pursue this matter any further. As I've already stated, I find no fault in this man.
Yes, Pilate, we do understand that. But under our law, this man is guilty. And if he were not guilty, then we wouldn't have brought him to you.
Guilty of what? Healing somebody? Centurion, have this man flogged as a token of Roman justice.
Marcus, prepare the scourging post. Antilles, get these people out of here. captives. Loose him. I saw him going through Jerusalem the other day as king of the Jews. He's no king! And what's a king without a robe? Give me a robe. Purple. A royalty for a king. What's a king without a crown? Give me a crown. Come here. Put this on him. Blindfold him. You call yourself a prophet? Who smoked you? Put it on there. Yeah. Put it on there tight. Pick him up. Take him back to Pilate.
Behold, I bring him forth to you that you may know that I find no fault in this man. Centurion, release him.
Release him!
Look at the man. He's been beaten, spit on, and humiliated. He's done nothing worthy of death. Centurion, release the
man. Release him!
Pilate, under our law, this man is guilty. He claims to be our Messiah. He's a blasphemer.
He claims to be the Son of God. He says that he can forgive sin. He says he is a king.
And that is treason.
Exactly, Pilate. That's treason.
Do you hear what they're saying about you? Answer me. Who are you? What are you? Why don't you speak? You want to die? Don't you know that I have the power to crucify you or to set you free?
You have no power except that which is given to you from above.
This man's done nothing worthy of death. Centurion, release him.
Release him!
Pilate, if this blasphemer is not crucified, then you yourself are committing high treason.
Pilate, this man says that he's a king. Not just a king, but a king that's even greater than Caesar Tiberius. So, Pilate, are you going to administer Roman justice, or are you going to commit treason against Caesar?
Pilate, he called
himself a king! High priest! Why do you take me as some sort of fool? How dare you make a mockery of Roman justice?
Pilate, this Jesus of Nazareth has caused nothing but trouble in our religion. And if you don't crucify him, you are committing treason against Caesar.
Exactly, Pilate. That's treason.
Pilate, please have nothing to do with this just man, for I've suffered many things this day in a dream because of him.
Oh,
Pilate, you have to do the right thing. Clear the way! Clear the way! Move it!
I've made my decision. I've examined this man, and I find no fault in him, and therefore I wash my hands of his blood. However, as a sign of Caesar's magnanimity and benevolence, I have a custom of releasing a prisoner sentenced to death for your Passover. Here we have two prisoners. One, Jesus of Nazareth, who perverts the people and you call King of the Jews.
No, yes.
or Barabbas, accused of sedition and murder.
Yes, Barabbas.
Which do you choose? Jesus, King of the Jews, or Barabbas, an enemy of Rome?
Yes.
Then let it be written that I, Pontius Pilate, release Barabbas.
Release him!
And deliver unto you Jesus to be crucified. Let it also be known that I find no fault in this man, and his blood be upon you, you, and your children. Clear the court.
Bring him. Move.
Come on, Messiah.
Move.
Come on.
Get away! It's too late!
going to die. It's over. It's over. It's over!
Go ahead.
Pick him up. Put him on the cross.
Drive the nails in my hands. Laugh at me. Where to stand? Go ahead and say it isn't me. The day will come when you will see. 'Cause I'll rise again.
On his arm.
There's no power on earth can tie me down. Yes, I'll rise again. Death can't keep me in the ground.
Hold that other arm.
Go ahead and mark my name, my love.
One more nail. This is your nail. Your nail. Your silence was deafening.
And bury me, but very soon I will be free, 'cause I'll rise again. There's no power on earth can tie me down. Yes, I'll rise again.
Gonna die. It's too late.
Death can't keep me in the ground.
Let's pick him up! Pick him up! Behold! Your King! Cast lots for this. I'm gonna win this road. Yeah. You got special powers, King. See how good you are. Ah, you're worthless. Told you I'd win. I didn't need him. See if he's thirsty. Not thirsty, huh? Where's that sign at? Don't need to know where who he is. I'll show you, he's just like everybody else. Ha! Bleeds blood and water. Just like everybody else. Let's leave. If we come back, he's still living, we'll break both of his legs. Let's go.
I had never known pain like I felt on that cross, and yet I was not alone in my suffering. As my mother stood before me and looked upon her son, she too suffered.
Is this the boy I raised? Is this the son I knew? Is this the one I love? Why can't they love? What has my son ever done to you? Has he caused you some pain? As I recall, all he's shown is love. Why can't you show him the same? This is the boy I raised. This is the son I knew. This is the one I've loved. Can't you love him too? Oh, what can
The last person I remember laying eyes upon was a Roman centurion. I thought how strange that this one who had caused me so much pain should be closest to me at the end. Where were my disciples? Where were those I healed? Where were those I fed? My eyes once again came upon this one who didn't even believe. But I knew it was for this one that I came. My Father so loved the world that he sent me so that whoever would believe in me would not perish, but have eternal life. Maybe through all this, he too would believe.
I'm the one who spat upon the Savior. I'm the one who mocked his holy name. I'm the one who said with all the rest, crucify him. I'm the one, I'm the one to blame. I'm the one who made him go to Calvary. I'm the one who nailed him to the tree.
Look what I've done.
The gates and doors were barred and all the windows fastened down. I spent the night in sleeplessness and rose at every sound. Half in hopeless sorrow and half in fear the day would find the soldiers breaking through to drag us all away. And just before the sunrise I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle and a voice began to call. So I hurried to the window, looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches and the sound of soldiers' feet. But there was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. John stood there beside me as she told me where she'd been. She said they'd moved him in the night and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away and now his body isn't there. So we both ran toward the garden and John ran on ahead. We found the stone and empty tomb just the way that Mary said. But the winding sheet they wrapped him in was just an empty shell. And how or where they'd taken him was more than I could tell. Oh, but something strange had happened there, just what I did not know. John believed a miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation couldn't lift me very high, 'cause I'd seen them crucify him and I saw him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. And everything I'd promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. And even if he was alive, it wouldn't be the same. Then suddenly the air was filled with a strange and sweet perfume. The light that came from everywhere drove shadows from the room. And Jesus stood before me with his arms held open wide. Then I fell down on my knees and I just clung to him and cried. Then he raised me to my feet, and as I looked into his eyes, the love was shining out from him like sunlight from the skies. Guilt and my confusion disappeared in sweet release, and every fear I'd ever had just melted into peace.
Hallelujah. He is alive. We're so thankful to all of our cast and everybody that has participated. If you enjoyed that, give them a round of applause. Question was posed to me yesterday, what's my very favorite part of the play? And I had one scene that really, well, two scenes that came to mind. One of them is because I'm a parent. And as Mary knelt at Jesus' feet and wept, I understood that pain. I understood what she felt in that moment. And I couldn't imagine giving my child to die the way that God the Father gave His Son. The greatest gift we have ever known, God gave. My other favorite scene is when the Roman centurion bowed before the Messiah, the one that he would realize gave his life. That scene means so much to me because that's all of us. Represented in the one part of the play